Figma just launched an AI website builder, and in this video, you're going to find out if it is better than Lovable. It costs $20 to try out. I spent the money, and I do a complete walkthrough in this video, so you can make the decision for yourself if it is worth your money. Here we are in Figma Make. This is a brand new AI designer, and it is in beta right now, and I've paid the $20 so that I can test it out and show you what it looks like and how well it works. So I'm going to go ahead and click Get Started, and here we are inside of Figma Make. So there's a couple different ways we could use it. First, you can, it looks like you can add Figma designs to Figma Make, or you can just start from scratch. So I'm going to just click I want to create a signup flow. And then by default, it looks like we have a prompt that was added for us. Here on the bottom, you can attach a design, image, select a library, or point and edit. And then you can also, actually, you can't select your model, but it is using Sonnet 4. So I'm going to go ahead and send this away. And here I can see it's thinking this is going to be very similar to any of the other AI app builders that you have seen out there. On the left side, we have the kind of the chat. On the right side, we have the code and the preview. So we have code here, preview. This also is making more sense why Figma sent that. I don't know if you saw this, but maybe a month or two ago, there was some controversy on Twitter because Figma sent a cease and desist letter to Lovable because Lovable used the term, I think it was like dev mode, which Figma, I guess, had trademarked. I'm not really too sure of all the legality of it, but I know that they went after Lovable. Lovable turned it into kind of a win for them on a PR thing stunt because they tweeted out how, you know, they're the small startup and Figma's the big company, so they positioned themselves that way. But I can see why Figma was trying to protect that, given that they have built a very similar app here to what Lovable looks like. So they have their preview, they have the code. Although, funny enough, they're not using that dev mode term here. But they have definitely built something that looks similar to Lovable. We can see the code as it's being written. And what I'm curious about is what the final result is going to be like. Is this going to look like a Figma file that we can, you know, export as a Figma file? Or is it going to be more like code that we would, you know, be able to use as code? So here we are. Okay, pretty cool. We have a comprehensive user-friendly signup flow. And now there's kind of some indicators, which is nice. It says you can try it out, then hop into the chat with new ideas to make changes. You can point and edit, select anything in the preview, and then drop your changes in the chat or edit with the tools. Okay, we'll test that out in a second. And share your creation in a full screen. Okay, and then you can also publish it on a Figma domain or connect your own. Okay. Awesome. So here we are, and looks like, and this is kind of like a mockup, which is pretty cool. So the question is like, is this going to end up being used more for just mockups, or is it going to be used for more like fully functional websites? So we have this mockup. See, so it has some functionality built in as well of like that. Here, if we click on point and edit, this is pretty nice. So like, let's say I click on this so I can change all of the design. Okay, this is really cool, actually. I like this. This is a cool feature that I haven't seen before, this ability to ask for changes. So let's say make it blue. Like, let's say I just wanted to ask for changes. Okay, so then what it's going to do is essentially just take that, put it into the chat anyway, and then ask the AI to make the update. So while it's doing that, let's go ahead and click play here. So if I click that play button here, now I can view this in kind of a screen that could be shared, which is nice. And then there's also the ability to make a copy of this, which I'm guessing is going to duplicate the file and then bring me into a new kind of like Figma Make environment here. And then if I click publish, I can publish the site. So from what I'm seeing here, Figma Make is more like a mockup generator. It doesn't look like it has like backend built in right now the way that Lovable or Bolt does. But otherwise, it looks very similar. And I'm sure just because they have such a massive user base and trust they're going to have a lot of people using this just who are Figma users who are then going to use this for their AI mockups. Now, the one thing, it doesn't look like this is like a Figma file that I can then put inside of Figma. It looks like it's like a separate product from what I can see. Okay, yeah, and I did a little bit more research in the documentation. It looks like that is the way it is. So you can go from, you know, Figma file to Figma Make and bring in that Figma file for inspiration, but you can't go the other way around. Okay, what are my takeaways? One, would I use this over something like Lovable? I think right now I would personally still want to use Lovable because it has that backend functionality. For just mockups, this does seem like a really great tool. It looks like they're going to bundle this into their subscription. So this is going to be a really competitive product because there's a lot of people who already have Figma Pro subscriptions and are just going to use this tool because it's all integrated. They don't need to also subscribe to a tool like Lovable, especially if they only need it for like mockups. Now, if you need to have something with more functionality, that's when you need to use different AI coding tools. So I will say my first impression is pretty good. I think this is pretty impressive, just everything they've built here. The designs themselves, like I'm sure they have something in the background to like maybe modify the system prompt a little bit, but everyone's using the same model. So if it's Claude Sonnet 4, like you're probably going to get relatively similar results with, you know, different tools. But they did, you know, integrate images, and there's probably more that they are doing in the background to potentially make these mockups better. So we'll need more testing here to see if that's the case. I do recommend checking it out. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more first looks into AI tools like this and more AI and no-code tips and tricks. We cover a lot on this channel, trying to keep you updated. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.